I was sitting over there minding my business when someone came over saying, "We want you to introduce somebody." I said, "Okay, I don't mind on anything." So I'm here to introduce a young man who is an outstanding athlete at Westinghouse High School. I met this young man in 1974. In 1974, we had a problem finding someone to fill in for an outstanding quarterback over the previous years. When we got down to practice, we were looking all over the place. The guy we had, he was all thumbs. He couldn't throw a ball 10 yards. So we said, "Holy smokes, we gotta find somebody." And one of the kids said, "Coach Webb, Ahmad can play quarterback." I said, "Ahmad who?" He said, "Ahmad, he played quarterback for the Little League team last year." So I called, "Ahmad, come here, let me see." I said, "Ahmad, throw me the ball." He stood back about 10 yards. And I said, "Throw it at him, throw it at him." And he threw the ball, boom, stuck right there. I said, "Do that again." He threw it again, straight as an arrow, boom. I said, "You're our quarterback." Two passes. I said, "You're our quarterback." He was in ninth grade. And some of the guys on the coaching staff said, "Is he allowed to play?" I said, "Yeah, he can play. He's in ninth grade. He's eligible. He's our quarterback." In 74, Ahmad led the city league in passing. He was a good runner and an outstanding leader. In 75, he was even better. In 76, when we went to the city league championship, we were playing Peabody. At halftime, the score was 20-0 Peabody. The second half, it was 20-0 Westinghouse. What happened was, Ahmad started running, he started throwing the ball, and he was doing some things that a lot of people still can do. In 1976, his senior year, he was All-City. Again, by the way, he made All-City, to my knowledge, 4 years. That's almost unheard of. Almost unheard of. Ahmad, more so than a football player, was a leader. I remember in 74, we had about 15 kids on the football team. 15 kids. What do they call them, Mom? The mean 13 or something like that? You mean that, right? I mean, these guys played offense and defense and special teams. They were tough. They were tough. We would tell them, "You're not allowed to get hurt. Unless you know you don't get hurt." Right? At the house, you don't get hurt. You just play. So, without further ado, I'm not going to be like Larry. I ain't going to stand up here and talk a lot. So, Ahmad Shareef.
Friday, I would open my window and I'd hear that Westinghouse forever. And I knew when I took that, worked that route down through the tunnels, I would be a true dog. Mr. Webb said, great coach. I started in ninth grade. I was real fortunate. I had a good backing of football players. I always had strong players. I was able to fit right into that puzzle. Through my years, I went to the University of Minnesota. I was recruited by Tony Dungy. I also was David Mann, Man of the Year, where I met Doug Williams, which was probably one of the first black college quarterbacks that I knew, somebody I could emulate. I went to the University of Minnesota. I left there, and after 25 years, I became a Pennsylvania State Trooper. 25 years. I retired about 5 years ago. I'd like to thank the committee, first of all, also for recognizing my father, who was probably one of my biggest mentors, Mr. Pete Sheffield, known as Ahmad Shareef as well. Mr. Heffin here, going back a couple of years ago, Westinghouse had no uniforms. Somebody stole our uniforms. Mr. Heffin, Mr. Hawkins, my dad, a couple other people got together. Their own resources and they would get uniform before Friday. This man, Mr. Heffin, has taught me a lot of life. Thank you, Mr. Heffin. I'd like to thank all you inductees. Congratulations.